is very curious about what's in the bag. She loves clothes, and I mean, she loves shopping. Anything I bring in here in bags, shopping bags, she wants to know. She needs to know. She put her whole snout in here when I initially brought it in. So, the first thing that I have to show you guys is actually not clothing. So, I'm gonna start with it because I feel like that makes more sense. I'm sorry if I'm like awkwardly placed and you can't see my face at all. It's more about the clothes. So, this is the very first item. Isn't that cute? So it's a kind of wall hanging, as you can see on the back. There's like, sorry, there's a huge freaking stain. I'm gonna have to wash this. But there's these little holes, and by the way, don't look at my nails. They're horrible right now. It's why I won't be doing any tapping of any sort today. It's just whispered rambles. I think you can put batteries in here, but if you look on the side, there's also a little USB. That's really loud. First up is this, and it's so freaking cute, you guys. So, it's actually two pieces. I did four, two pieces. It's a little tank top that's kind of different and funky, and I mean, I like it. I like this kind of top. It's kind of, you can see on the back, there's a little, it says SP, I don't know that brand at all. It's kind of see-through though, like the cups are not see-through, but the stomach part and the back kind of is see-through, and it came with this little shrug. It says the brand is called the shoulders, but like barely. It's very summery and a beautiful burnt orange color and kind of girly, and I know exactly how I'm going to style this. Next up, I have some jogging pants. If you know me, you know I'm in jogging pants most of the time. I got these really nice joggers. They have pockets. I need pockets. I'm actually taking your dog out for a walk in the rain, put your phone in your pockets, and then as you're jogging along, it jumps out, falls into the wet grass, and you lose it for a couple of hours. I've done that. I just hit the microphone. Luna is like really liking these pants. I have to wash these after, and then I'm going to film like maybe a try on. Do you guys like this shirt? Of this clothing haul. I think these are all summer dresses. Okay, so that's what I was looking for mostly. First one I got. Now, this kind of makes me think of like a 90s kind of a vibe. I would pair these with some thick platform kind of booties, maybe. Like, it's a dress. She just enjoys the thrift store smell. Next up, this dress. Okay, the reason why I like this dress, you guys might think I'm really weird, but I don't care. This dress really reminds me of the horror movie The Ring. And I'm going to show it to you guys. So it's this. Skin tight, pretty long dress. All of the dresses I got go past my knees because I like that look. I like long, kind of snaky silhouette dresses, bodycon maybe, but I don't like showing off my knees. I like long sleeves too, but I mean, it's summer. Look at this. I find if you could actually see the fabric in real life, you could see that it really kind of looks like a staticky screen, like a gray staticky screen, and there's all these weird little rings of light that look like the inside of a well. Samara. My Samara dress. Yeah, so it makes me think of the movie The Ring, so I bought it because I'm ridiculous. I haven't even been showing you guys the prices. This one was, wow, $9.99. That's a little bit much for like just a dress like this, but I think this was all the new stuff they just got. Oh my god, I love this one. I'm so excited. Okay, so if you guys have watched American Horror Story Coven, you might know what I mean when I say that this is going to be my Fiona Good dress. It's a black dress that goes all the way past my knee. Luna likes this one as well. You can try it on, girly, but I don't think it's gonna fit. I'm sorry. And as you can see, the top of it, get off me, girly. Oh, she's really sniffing it. Oh, yeah. So the top of it is like this cool knitted kind of mesh fabric. It's got long sleeves. It zips up the back with a little hook right here. And it's got this long cut up, all knitted cut out right here at the front between the boobs. It looks so good on me. I'm going to pair this. I know exactly how. Maybe with a black umbrella. It's going to be really Halloween-y, but I don't care. Maybe I'll dress up as the Supreme for Halloween. Who knows? Don't mess with the Supreme, bitch. Up next, another weird dark dress. So shows your back a little bit, or your shoulder blades. It's a normal scoop neck, but it's this black and white kind of tie-dye that looks really smoky and shadowy and cool, and I find that, I mean, I can see, like, a huge skull on the back. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I see a face on the back of the dress, and it just, I don't know, I really liked this. I thought it was interesting, and I find that, you know, there's this little, at the bottom of it, there's this little cutout that makes it easier to walk in the dress because it's pretty long and it, like, locks the legs. But I think if it didn't have this little thing here, I probably wouldn't have bought it. Does that sound weird? I find that it's just the little details that make clothing. So, that dress will be comfortable when I'm walking a Luna who's, like, now on the other couch. Next up, I have this, which is so cool. It's really long, so I don't know how I'm gonna show you this. It's this really long white dress with this little crisscross kind of motif that kind of looks like if you were to, I'm sorry, I gotta move this, if you were to zoom in on, like, a bug screen in a window, like a screen, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like this is what it makes me think of. I like clothing for weird reasons, okay? So it's really long, very, very, very long. Like, it's, I'm gonna have to wear really tall platform shoes with this, and I know exactly the shoes. It's called these thin little spaghetti straps, which I love. And it's by a brand called Moon. So I don't know this brand. And it's got this cute little detail. It looks like a mini, like, supposed to be a bow, I guess, but I kind of like it untied like this. It looks like a little tie. It's cute. Yeah, so really flowy, like the kind of dress you don't have to shave your legs when you wear it, you know what I mean? Like, just, you're set. And, I mean, walk down the street in that, and I mean, it's freaking breathtaking. Summery. I might wear this more in the fall with some black sheer tights or something, but it's a long sleeve, kind of like thick wool, not wool material, but like, I don't know, it's pretty, looks pretty warm. What's in this? I don't even see what this is made of. Apparently it's from Forever 21, so hope I didn't pay a lot for this. It's like a again, goes past my knees. It's a bodycon dress, so you can see that it's kind of like, it's got a bit of a dip. Another dress with, like, yellow roses and red. The other dress, maybe that is similar. You know, what I notice is when I start shopping for clothing, I go for the same patterns. Like, I go through periods where I like stripes. Sometimes I like floral. Sometimes I like a certain color, or like a three or four colors I buy a lot of, like black, blue, white, gray, you know, blood red. I really like red, purple, green, lots of green. So it's got these long sleeves. It's kind of tight, but not that tight. Like, it's nice, it's flattering. And I will probably be wearing that when it gets a little bit like this for a while, and it's actually the dress that made me start to actually shop. I like to just walk around the thrift store and just go through racks and not actually pick anything out, and then just, you know, this is the dress that started a frenzy in the dress aisle, honestly, for me. It's a really long, really flattering, bright red dress with, like, a kind of a flowy neckline, I guess, and it's just so stuff a little bit more.